There's an old legend I've heard that if you go to the wharf in Santa Cruz, California, and if you walk to the end of the pier on the last day of the year, at the stroke of midnight, if you look south, you will see Canopus. Now, when I heard this story a few decades ago, I wondered a couple of things. Is the legend true? And if it is, what's so special about Santa Cruz? And maybe the most important question of all is, what is Canopus? Canopus is a bright star. Think of bright stars. The number one brightest star is Sirius. Okay, the sun is a star, and from the point of view of Earth, the sun is by far the brightest star. But the second brightest star and the brightest star of the nighttime sky is Sirius. And from the point of view of Earth, the third brightest star is Canopus. This is a nice picture of Canopus taken by the astronauts on the International Space Station. To find out if the legend about seeing Canopus on the stroke of midnight in Santa Cruz is true, I'm using the computer program Stellarium, and I've set it for the stroke of New Year, January 1st at midnight. And we're in Santa Cruz. I see some familiar stars of the winter sky, such as Orion, and the brightest star of all in the night sky, Sirius. And down here next to south, I do see Canopus. Now, it doesn't look so bright because Stellarium knows that Canopus is low, shining through the atmosphere and fog, so it won't look especially bright, but there it is. And I've switched the sky to Berkeley now, and I can't see Canopus from Berkeley. Let's go back to Santa Cruz. There's Canopus, Berkeley. It's not showing. Santa Cruz, Canopus, Berkeley, no Canopus. To investigate why we can see Canopus in one place but not another, consider the Earth. It's round like a ball, and a ball has no top or bottom. It's the same all around. But I positioned the Earth in this diagram with Berkeley and Santa Cruz near the top of your computer screen. And if you went around the Earth from Berkeley all the way back to Berkeley in a full circle, you'd go a full 360 degrees around. But going from Berkeley to Santa Cruz, you would have gone almost 1 degree. Let's see what difference that 1 degree makes. The shaded segment up at the top of the diagram here shows the part of the universe that you can see from Berkeley. Looking in any other direction, the Earth itself blocks your view. But now in Santa Cruz, we're a little bit ways around the Earth, and the segment of sky we can see from Santa Cruz is a little bit different, not a whole lot different. 1 degree makes it hard to tell that there's any difference. But if I show you the segment of the sky you can see in Berkeley and also the segment of sky you can see from Santa Cruz, you can see there's a little bit of sky you can see from Santa Cruz that you can't see from Berkeley. And it happens that the star Canopus is off in this direction, just in the part of the sky that you can see from Santa Cruz, but you cannot see from Berkeley. Now, when I see a diagram like this, I know it's got lots of parts. And sometimes I stop the video and check it out just to make sure I understand what all the parts are and what they're meant to show. A map like this gives us another way to think about the Earth, and we'll use this map to consider how far north or south something is. We describe how far north something is with a number called latitude. The shaded part at the top shows latitude 37 degrees and higher, and that just barely includes Berkeley. And in this shaded region, we can't see Canopus ever. But if we go south of 37 degrees latitude in this area of the map, and that includes Santa Cruz, then we can sometimes see the star Canopus. Think about places you might have been, or a place you've heard of, and see if you can use this map to see if you can tell whether you could see Canopus from that place. But these are winter stars that you can see from almost any place. So if the Earth is blocking your view of Canopus, or if a computer graphic is blocking your view of Canopus on a computer screen, you can still look for the bright stars of Orion or the brightest star of the night sky, Sirius. And if you go far enough south, you can look for Canopus. Speaking of Canopus, can a pussycat understand longitude and latitude?